Welcome to Transformation Hour with Bishop Samuel Noy Mensa, President of Full Gospel Church International, FGCI Ghana. Full Gospel Church is a Bible-believing church that's committed to helping people discover, develop, and use their gifts, talents, and abilities to enable them become useful and relevant to society, their communities, and to fulfill their life's mission on earth. At FGCI, we achieve this by helping people discover purpose to live for, people to share fellowship with, profession to live out, principles to live by, and power to live on.
Until you have a dream, no one will attack you. Until you know where you are going, no one will fight you.
We believe that anointed and pragmatic teaching is the catalyst for transformation in the lives of individuals and in the church. Hence our message, transforming lives on purpose.
Some complain about the problem. Others will find people to blame about the problem. Only few, the 20%, will fix the problem they encounter.
Full Gospel Church International is a place where we help people reconnect to God. Leaders are raised to be change agents, and talents and gifts are discovered and used.
No matter where you stand, somebody will tag you, but stand for Ghana.
At FGCI, we believe that every member is a minister and that we are saved to save others.
What will connect you to an auto mechanic is only when you have a problem with your vehicle. That is when you now look for an auto mechanic. So you see, problems bring people together in bad times.
We invite you to be our regular guest these and every Sunday on this network as we bring you a systematic and expository teaching of God's Word with Bishop Samuel Noy Mensa.
Don't look at things only from your own perspective. So learn to see things from somebody else's perspective. That is the only way you can appreciate the contributions. This morning is the Palm Sunday, and I'm speaking on the subject, don't live your life by chance. Don't live your life by chance. Don't live your life by ice accident. Don't live your life by try and error. Mark chapter 11, I will read the first 11 verses.
As
Jesus and his disciples approached Jerusalem, they came to the towns of Bethage and Bethany on the Mount of Olives. Jesus sent two of them on ahead. Go into the village over there, and he told them, as soon as you enter it, you will see a young donkey tied there that no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks, what are you doing? Just say, the Lord needs it and will return it soon. The two disciples left and found the colt standing in the street tied outside the front door. As they were untying it, some bystanders demanded, take note of that, what are you doing untying that colt? They said what Jesus had told them to say, and they were permitted to take it. Then they brought the colt to Jesus and threw their garments over it. He sat on it. Many in the crowd spread their garments on the road ahead of him, and others spread leafy branches they had cut in the field. Jesus was in the center of the procession, and the people all around him were shouting, praise God, blessing on the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessing on the kingdom of our ancestor David. Praise be to the heavens. So Jesus came to Jerusalem and went into the temple. After looking around carefully at everything, He left because it was late in the afternoon and then returned to Bethany with the disciples. May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of his word in Jesus' name. Can I have an amen?
Amen.
You may be seated. I am speaking on the subject, don't live your life by chance, don't live your life by accident, don't live your life by trial and error.
Okasa afa asema watu ni dinse entinasi ibiara biara.
We know that this story has to do with the triumphant entry of Jesus Christ. He's been going through Jerusalem often and often. He's been going to Jerusalem right from the time he was born. But this particular visit was unique, was historical, and was for a purpose.
We are asking for a name. I can kind now in saying that yes, Christ will write Jerusalem. I will acquire a sabre so free to buy a bofra. Now, so sign Morem Weno dear. Now, a BBRS, your shedding soon, a far near Nabrabon.
He went to Jerusalem in a great style. He went to Jerusalem with great recognition this time.
Weno dear, Obora Jerusalem.
Historically and prophetically, he was presenting himself to his own people for acceptance. According to God's own divine timetable, it was the moment of presenting the Messiah to his people. And for his people to acknowledge him as the king, to acknowledge him as the Messiah, to acknowledge and receive him.
Na ama nkrofono so ati na tum se oyohin ati na atum se oyẹ obi a oyẹ oje nkwa na ye wie as born o se.
Remember Galatians said concerning his birth, when the time that was appointed was due, he brought forth a child. He brought forth a child.
Kai se Galatia uma no amaye ti ase se abra nimre a ya shishama no eso ye no wo wo no.
Everything God did was according to time and plan. So in this particular day was a divine plan according to God himself that the son will present himself. And so when he got there and the priest and the high priest and the people, the high priest told him, look, get your people to be quiet.
And
you know what Jesus told them? He said, if you command these people to be, if you get these people to be quiet, we will command even the stones to rise up and to praise and to acknowledge this day.
Na Yesu. Na Yesu bua osofopono ka kire ne se se uma enkofu eyedi a na she abuo ma abuo asori ayedede yimaye.
This particular story has been recorded in all the four gospels.
Sa asem fua we se no o she Marko, Luca, eni Yohani, eni sa we nyina obi a tro sa asempai.
But each writer wrote it from a different perspective. Now, you can tell, you know that perhaps when there is an event or there is an activity or there is an accident in your city, in a town, or there is a serious situation where you have various journalists. You may have somebody from, you know, the media house, A, media house, B, from CNN, from Al Jazeera, from Joy, from, you know, GBC's. You know, TV3 and what have you, and TV in Africa and what have you. Each journalist will be writing the same story. But when you read throughout the four or five different journalists, you will realize that their stories may be different in terms of its approach and its presentation.
Nessa and Central for any about some mobile for a seminal at what the summer, Yenayatia. Do you free TV training a GBC, BBC Ninano, a Sam Crona no Munyamo Candia, Nanso, Obia, a tra a seminal, Emma, a knee at Danica Cra, every Mia Omujina, Diomuya, and Islamontias here at here.
But the core message would not be missed in their presentation.
Nanso assembly tin de and ye idea a beggar asking kaya assembly tin de ni na numuno ubonse at the whole play.
But his approach may be a little bit different.
Nanso quina omubefaso mubeka a semino ubia edini dieno ebe ba umbe danika kra.
So sometimes people say, well, the scripture is conflicting itself. No. The four gospel writers were writing it just like journalists, and they were writing from different perspectives. Whenever you read the book of Matthew, he wrote it specifically for the Jews. And in his writing, he wanted them, because the Jews are very much rooted in the Old Testament, and all that they know was about the Old Testament and what God has done with them. So anytime Matthew was writing, he wanted them to believe who the Messiah is. So at any time, he would connect it back to the Old Testament.
And you know, so Usha Matthew, see there or no extra on it, you know, or you for no free say, you for no there, I'm on him free, Mosem Rasa, the Pim Sam Raya, who yes, Christo no, I'm on him Bibia Bio, who can send Bia Shoma, a Monte, I just saw the Akofasa, a quino so, it's in Matio, eh, and I can say, or better, a seminal edia to two, a pump that dana munimuno, now mutimi edia to two, and who say, oh, I'm pa, Asama Matio Ekano, and Nunye.
So anytime he wrote, he would then say that it might be fulfilled according to the prophet, or according to the prophet Isaiah, or according to the prophet Jeremiah, or according to the prophet, you know, in the scriptures, that it might be fulfilled.
The scientists are looking kind mature. Ubehunsa otroa ekodu bebi anu makasa. Senior beya ebebem. Senior enkom shefono she enkom etuho. Ewo Isaiah mreno. Ana Jeremiah mreno. Ana Ezekiel mreno. Senior beya omubehunsa ampa. Asemnu ewo hadida ana esi. Ewo sa awonta toswimu.
The focus of John's message to the public was not to prove anything from the Old Testament, but to prove one thing, that Jesus is God. So each writer had a purpose for writing. And in the book of Matthew, when you read it, you know, Jesus did something that Mark did not record, because Mark's purpose was not for the Jews, but was for the Gentiles. And the Gentiles really didn't need those kind of details. So when Jesus got to the entrance into the Jerusalem and he stood on the mountain and he looked at the people and they asked him to be quiet, Bible said he looked at the city and he wept. He wept, he cried. He said, oh Jerusalem, if you knew this day and this hour of your visitation, you wouldn't behave like the way you are behaving now. I cry for you because you have missed your visitation.
Ain't you know, yeah, but trust him, sir. A bra, yes, to a bejna, a crona, no, no, shake, or money, this, or shake a crono, or swing, or diarrho, no, cause, oh, mim, crofo, moon nim, don't shake, and he marry a woman. If he says, I'm moon nim, don't shake, and he and me are your woman, and don't see an amis from him if he say, and Sasha, not a bad mammon, no, Shrisa and Sasha.
So John said he came unto his own, but his own did not receive him.
But
as many that received him, he gave them the power to become the sons of God. Because he was presented to his own, and his own did not receive him, and Jesus wept.
If he said,
if you could understand the timetable of God the Father for you people, you wouldn't have rejected me.
But
the time will come, this city you pride yourself will no more be this city. It will be bruised down, it will be wrecked down, it will be destroyed into pieces. It will be destroyed because you have missed your visitation. So I'm speaking on the subject, don't live your life by accident. Don't live your life by trial and error. Don't live your life by trial and error, but by accident. But live you and don't live your life by chance.
Ni senti ano se entinasi ebiara entinasi bisi basa maweni enda ho na hu emre a uwom.
Now you can understand why I have established this topic.
Afeni osofu etimi hu se yenwa dukunti a odisa asemti aba.
If you look at the scripture very carefully, number one principle I would like you to have and to learn, don't be an island alone. Don't be an island to yourself. Don't be an island. In verse 1, as Jesus and his disciples approached Jerusalem, they came to the towns of Bethany and Bethany on the Mount of Olives. Now, verse 1b, Jesus sent two of them ahead. Now, in verse 4, the two disciples left and found the court standing in the street, tied outside the front door. Jesus sent two and he did not send one. In this life, it is very important that you cannot walk alone, you cannot be an island, but you know, there is the need that we need to be able to build a team, because in this situation we find ourselves, one person alone cannot get things done. So there is a need to build a team. There is a need to work with one another to achieve greater and better results. If we need to have a great church service, it will not depend on one person alone in this house. For example, we need the usher to be effective in their management. To receive people with smile and to receive people so that they can feel good that they are coming to church. We need the greeters to be very pleasant with the people. The parking lot of us officers will be able to be nice to the people and show them where to park. The prayer force is busy praying for God's anointing over the service, for the presence of God to be felt in the service. Department is very intentional with the selection of the songs and to make sure that whatever they do in the their song presentation and music will inspire everybody.
And you to follow so at the new one and what name mu a brain I say and cry and you might add there now to me to be what we are seeing one a ye.
The media is making sure that every projection is good. You know, we have quality projection, we have quality information on our screens, and they are linking us to the rest of the world. Everybody wants to establish his own company. Everybody, so because of that, everybody's company is just small. And we can't build a very strong organization because everybody is building his own. But people can come together and form a group of companies that can be very effective and very powerful.
And then, Uncle Yeno, Obia, Abomadis, Obebi, Onua, Nejuma, Eti, Ama, in Yumakoni, Naya, in Kitten, you may ask to say in a Becabum, Nati may be in Yuma Akasia, I want to be called Nichi, I bet me a Riasa Fanenano, I pray.
When we come together and you work together, you bring your strength, I bring my strength, and we strengthen one another to achieve a better goal.
Say, Kaya Hubomwa, made my one name banner the one who are the Abba. Now, yet me a Pia Ama Adena, I can say, now you need to idea Unina, Yena Yehu.
So Jesus sent two. It was not by accident. Jesus had the power of team and sent two people to go and perform an assignment.
Yes, Esuma Mienu, and yes, no onim dia oye, and asa and from so anaye, onim se mienuno, a ye in kabum, it is a mienuno omukwa, omutimi a ye emane a ye to suma mienuno.
Because when the work is too big, the two will be able to shoulder them.
If you say yes, Benuswa in Bimia, so I'm gonna say a juma no eswa, omu bet me asumu fefe.
Now, number two. Learn to plan ahead. Learn to plan ahead. Now in verse 2, Jesus said, go into the village there of you. He told them, you enter it, you will see a young donkey tied there that no one has ever ridden. Untie it and bring it. Jesus was aware of the visit. He was aware that he needed certain, things that it will help him to achieve his goal.
Now, Jesus nim se obe ra Jerusalem sa ekwane so na onim akadienzo na obehia amasa akwentu no esipi.
So he planned ahead. He just didn't get up and said, "Oh, well, now we need to go to Jerusalem. Let's go and figure out what are we going to take with us." And we. We needed a donkey, we needed some few things, but how can we find them?
Yes, Jerusalem.
He knew where the donkey was. He knew where the donkey was located. He had planned ahead of his journey. So he just didn't get up and try to find a solution to the problem.
Now,
when you plan ahead, it helps you to think ahead. It helps you to be able to fix the necessary problem that is ahead of you. You think in advance what is to be done, when it should be done, how it will be done, and who will have to do it.
emre a ya wose ye ye bibi nia obeye bibi ani kwa ye befa so a ye beye bibi wo sa enema we nyina wo wi a woka se na wan ana ebeye sa de no na wa pani nyina anu ye.
What is to be done, when it will be done, how it will be done, and who will have to do it. Learn and develop a savings culture that whatever you receive, you will open a savings account, put some money there in times of trouble.
Man poly aton chain. If we say yes, see Udi Kwedua, and now why then Udi Usum Bodia Sumkedu na come back.
You don't live your life and spend everything you get on your fried rice and all your lifestyle and all of your dresses. You don't spend everything you earn. Learn to keep some for tomorrow.
Muma yensia see there ye di bibia di besie ama echina. Ebi no mo ha amon pa mohung goton kung and nam no ori no upon the
because you see, everybody thinks that tomorrow there will still be a deal. Tomorrow there will still be the sales. And especially when you are writing and doing a they know that every day they will have something they will receive. So they never plan to save something
against their future.
What plans do you have for 2021? What plans do you have for the next 5 years of your life? Jesus planned the day he started his ministry. He planned for this day and for the donkey to, you know, to lift him up, or for him to sit on the donkey for his assignment.
Jesus Christ,
I'm speaking on the subject. Don't live your life by accident. Number three, communicate clearly. Communicate clearly. Look at his communication. Go into the village over there, he told them. As soon as you enter it, you will see a young donkey tied there that no one has ever ridden on it. Untie it and bring it here. The communication was clear. Clear message. It was precise. It was concise. There was no ambiguity, no confusion. The people understood what he was saying.
Asema Yesu kache omono na emu daho entiasye wum. Asema kache omono eye pepepe ose. Munko ekro na ewo yenimuno. Hey, unya po remu pe ube wo efunum a yatichre no. Sa efunum ye efunum bia ubia entina soda. Se u sa efunum na sane no. Na sa infano ebremi ewa ha. Sa ane Yesu kain sa wansi asia enunye.
Sometimes you have someone who come to you, would talk and talk and talk, and at the end of the day, they're like, can you start all over? I don't seem to understand what you are saying.
Ubiwa otimi kasa na
if we want to have a better life, if we don't want to live by accident, learn how to communicate well. Sometimes we said something and say, "We are kasakeke." That is not kasakeke. Let's move on. Number four, be innovative and creative. Be innovative. Find a way of doing things differently. He said there is a court in verse 2b. No one has ever sat on it. Be creative. find different ways of doing things better. Find different ways of doing things that will help you to achieve better results. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Number five, be a problem solver. Solve problems. If you don't live your life by error, solve problems. You know what it is? He told them, go to that town. There is a donkey there.
Or say, Monko sa e kroniso, e funumubi ewo.
But Pastor Freddy said, in case someone comes to prevent you, to become an obstruction, and to ask you why, this must be your answer. He anticipated a possible problem. He anticipated a possible challenge, and he prepared himself to meet that problem and to solve it.
Okachira mo se, se mo kona mo sane e funumu no, na se anko ni ye no obi be bisa o se aten ti na wo sane e funumu na, o Jesus Christo adwin ko enim se, e bia na osi akwan bi aba be twintwa mo anemu, na se osi akwan no e ba, mo fa sa emoye wei ana emma no.
I read an article in about Japan, and we are told that Japanese educators had long talked about the need to shift from memorization-focused education to problem-solving-focused education. You know, so that to have a better education, they want to move away from memorization of education to a problem-solving education.
Also for poor King Kansen Fabi, knocking Kayano. Aye, Japan for Omo Oma Quatri, our quiet dear Adisia Echo Enimono. Omo say, I was at Japan for Omo free, sir, a quina, yet say to for your canny, ye chew and your ma editu, ye trim, na ye bisawa, na wakano, ye free, sir, Adisiano. Na yam share kwanya ye de adisuano ebe so enna o how our wo wiase no ye de adisuano ebe pe emoye e ti amba omo.
Our educational system didn't prepare us and does not prepare us to solve problems.
Eye ye gana ase no ye adisuano an share kwanya ye be fa so ye be so ye how our wo ye so enne no na anko ye no.
The problem why our political leaders can't fix our problems, it is not their fault.
Hey, also for policy, you find chomo, you find chomo. At the good sea, you how I want you so. I'm on your phone, no enemy, and so I only say, or three times I had a more call, I bet the sack of him, Japomono.
The schools they went to and the training they had didn't prepare them to solve problems.
Adisiana ya de mambo no bebi enwa e chiamu kwan ayefaso ayedeso ensemwano.
And therefore they are working in a higher responsibility and they don't know how to solve problems, and if it is a problem of the road, they would wait perhaps for a big man to tell them what to do. The big man will also wait for the minister to tell them what to do. The minister will also wait for the president to tell them what to do. Most often you hear the president, I have instructed the minister to do this. I've instructed the IGP to do this. Every day the president is instructing people to do. Why can't they know what to do? Because the education they have didn't prepare them to think out the box and to be able to solve problems without people telling them what to do. Our educational system is chew, pour, pass, and forget. So the education has not produced thinkers. The education has not produced problem solvers. The problem of our situation in Ghana is the problem of the kind of education we are having.
So for a say, or how I why I saw our baby Ghana has it no. Ninano, Ninano, Wabon, Tofa, S.A., and ye acquire your first one, your detective, and say, I dear was school. No, now say, ye call, sir, or how are you one Bakumo to say, and find ye crying, and ya. Obia, you're a dinner, or you're a big man. Neni, Edawa, or chain, or swafo, no, a chain, sir, or my penny, a betreno, sir, or ye. Na also for Ponce, I then no moon nim obianim na sedia, na and ne ubetino no mampini, Makatra IGP se on your way, Makatra minister we se on your way, Makatra obintin se on your way, Yakatra we se on your say, I then if you saw obianim adia or so o ye, ni fire by ninjinane se, omu cause to go a cot tea omono, yan titi omo, ah omu ankasa omu pimono. On my genuine mutiko bet my trauma say, Sa or Howe, Nimri, I say a son, and Nunia, just all chain, and Mamma Penny, or be banned up a son, no, what's
not for me? Cut it short for me. Try to summarize it, please. Now, there is a note on a particular education I came across, it said in the a notice on the one of the universities in South Africa. And it says, that's at the entrance of the university in South Africa, the following message was posted there. Destroying a nation does not require the use of atomic bombs or the use of long-range missiles. It only requires lowering the quality of education.
South Africa. Kan yɛ ne sɛ sɛ wo pɛsɛ wo sɛ ɔman bi a ɛhu yɛ sɛ wo bɛsɛe bomb ɛde asomɔm wɔ anaasɛ wodi akodeɛ bi bɛkɔ ɔmo so deɛ hia ne sɛ ɔmo adesua no wobɛte so na aba fam.
Said allowing cheating in the examinations by the students, and then when you allow them to cheat in the examination, patients would die in the hands of such doctors, buildings would collapse at the hands of such engineers. Money is lost at the hands of such economists and accountants. Humanity dies at the hands of religious scholars. Justice is lost at the hands of judges and lawyers. And the collapse of education is the collapse of of the nation. The collapse of education is the collapse of the nation.
As I say, what say at the Siana? Now, on binding, I say, if you say, Sir, oh, Bramo, no Mujia, our Abramotro examiner, dear Bebani, say, a doctor for no Umbekun Grofo, a diamond Bubekun Grofoso, a chrono, and this council, a Bajira, our Kuntabufonso, and Sam.
And what they have said is exactly what describes our nation.
We prepare, and I am my new woman, and nay.
Why is it that mothers will die when they are going to bring forth a child? In this 21st century, in 2021, why would pregnant mothers be lying on the floor? Something is wrong with our educational system. And we complain that the people are corrupt. But if I come to you and my secretary has to type a letter and she has to do it 4-5 times, making mistakes, then she is not competent. If a carpenter, you get your carpenter and then the carpenter does a work for you and then brings the dining table, and within 3 months that dining table is destroyed, it is the same like the road minister doing the road, and 3 months or 5 months it is damaged. Because you see, but we only think about the road minister that he's not competent, he's corrupt. But that carpenter who did the table for you and in 3 months it got damaged, he's equally corrupt.
Road minister, nanso aya na ye nya ya de ensa akwachre minister ne de ne so carpenter ni tie osofo se wo so ti se minister ne pepe
if a dressmaker you make a dress and the dress you know can't fit me and it's so bad, you are just the same like the minister who is doing his work and is not doing it well. We only complain about what they are doing, but you are equally like them. Because you know why? Because they came from amongst us. And so they came from a situation where they don't do quality job. And at that level, they still can't do a quality job. Number six, be good observers. Be good observers. Be good observers. Jesus, verse 5. And as they were untying, some bystander demanded, "What are you doing? Untying that cord?"
Or see. Yesu e catch omo wie omo ko na mo ko sane efunu no nkofu bia no mu jaw anye be sha da di for ne catch omo say dai na mo ye mo sane efunu no ana.
Be a good observer. You see, there are times things happen in our community and then you are passing by, they ask you, can you describe the man who broke that house or who broke into that house or who stole that thing? You can't even describe the person. You don't even know the shirt he was wearing. You can't describe his outfit. You can't give an estimate about his height. What about the car? You can't tell about the color of the car. You know, we are only in a society, but there are no good observers.
Anko ye no obi be pa won akoye boni bi na be bi say o o de opa won sisi akoye yi no when we fi say wan hwe atare e hwe no ne tinti so ye tuntum so ye tietia ka o tim ka number we hu bibia ni wa hu ye adentia onam saa we ni hwe soro won hwe hwe osofo se mama ye ni enna ho na ye hwe enwoma etwa ye we hia.
Two people were untying the knot. They were untying the donkey, and whilst they were doing that, someone who was passing by stood and challenged, "What are you doing?"
Nenipa benu na esani efunumu no na obi a otwemo hu sa mo sane efunumu no ogyina bi so mo se na etien na moye.
A strange vehicle in your within your community and neighborhood, 3-4-5 times parking the car at an odd time, you don't even ask a question.
Ka bia be gyina wo dan echi wa ko nenim kakra we gyina ho nom eh wa mbisa no kra se adenti anona mo nanso wo man tem.
We don't have good observers. One day a professor sent a group of medical students who have reported for the first time in school, and he was trying to teach them the skills of observation.
Eya obi a o che nkwala de de omoko baby so okoche mo ade a so omo hwe.
And it was pathologic, the pathology department. So they put a dead body in that department. And then the professor said, "As medical students, I want to teach you, nothing should be ugly to you. Nothing should look nasty to you. As a medical doctor, you should be able to absorb anything and to look at anything."
And says somebody be your time. Say we are doctor near one year. You be got if you know the shame be your time.
And so they brought the dead body, and then the professor, took his finger and inserted into the anus of the dead body and then licked the finger. And then he told all the students, the 20 of them, "Every one of you do the same." And now they were looking at each other. Ah, let me be a medical school pioneer. I mean, they were looking at, how do I do this?
So
the professor said, "That is why you are in medical school. First year in medical school, we want to program your mind." So every one of them inserted the finger into the dead body's back passage and will leak. And then you can see the face. They squeezed the face. I mean, it was horrible for them. And then they wondered. So the professor asked them, Did you see me squeezing my face? They said, "No, we didn't see you squeezing your face. You were normal."
And then
he said, you know, as students and medical doctors, you must be very smart and be observant. He said, I use my index finger to insert the back passage of the dead body, but I lick my middle finger. And so you have failed to learn the skills of observation. So Jesus is teaching us, if you want to live a life not by chance, learn to observe well. Use all your senses to know what is happening around you.
Yes,
on the day of this triumphant entry, don't live your life by accident. What Jesus did was planned to redeem us and to save us. And these are the lessons we can learn, that our life can be better, our life can bring honor and glory to Him.
We acquire. And then acquire men can so question that no. When and some fire, yes, Christo Bepesa or Beba, Yadi Yajini Yakuma, a better sooner Yajin Jinho, say a person, Yabrabon, a co enim, Nayam Bob Brat said the year to Tatadia, Yamma Yeni and Naho, Nay Yambo Yabra, Nayam Co and Cos Emfa and Coswa Emra Yeni Yamai.
Would you rise on your feet, please?
Mama answering in Yina and I so.
Learn to plan ahead. Learn to solve problems that will confront you. Learn to communicate well so that you will not be misunderstood. And visit the challenges and the possibilities of problems and how to solve them. And learn to be a great observer. Watch around, know things around you. For some of you, you don't even know your shirt size. You don't even know your trouser size. You don't even know your shoe size. And for the women, you don't even know your size. Whether you're a size 16 or an 18 and a 20, you don't know. You don't know your bust. You don't know whether you wear a cap A, cap B, cap C, brazier. You just don't know anything about yourself. This is Africa. Learn to know things about yourself. So that when you even go to the hospital, you can help the doctor to take good care of you.
Hospital doctor blood group there.
You should know things. Yes, you should know things about your own blood group. You should know that. You should know your height. You should know your weight. You should know things that whether you have a diabetic problem, whatever it is, you should know something about yourself. That is observation. Before an ailment will be critical, it gives us a warning sign. And God has blessed us with one of the senses of feeling. You begin feeling something. And when you start feeling, don't ignore those feelings. They are warning signs of something happening in your body.
Learn to observe things about yourself. Learn to observe things about your children when they are behaving differently, and then you will be able to know whether now they have started drugs or doing something bad. A parent was with just children, and they never knew that for 3 years the boy was on drugs. He would prepare tea with drugs and drink in the house, and parents didn't know.
Mami bi ene ne ba eti mfie biensa ne ba no enum edubone or the good team no anum etodan bodi maami na nuansu o shekoma no oni mbusa nsu sha de ma ne ba no na odi num edubone.
May God help us.
Ya menya ye boafo
that we will not live our lives by chance. Like Jesus, you will go with victory for a good purpose. Let's look to the Lord in prayer as the group sings.
Wow. Transformation Hour. It's been another wonderful time of transforming God's people through the word of the Lord. Susan, I don't know, but I think today's message was awesome.
Yes, today's message was indeed powerful, and I believe everyone from all across the world has been blessed by this life-transforming message by our Bishop S.N. Mensah.
It appears we are not the only people blessed by this message. We have a few messages here that we want to share with you to tell you about the wonderful things that God is doing in the life of His people. I have one here from Jafaru Al-Hassan. He says that, I am a Muslim, but I like this great visionary bishop. Sir, you are truly a man of God. May God bless you. Your preaching shows you are a patriotic citizen. I don't know if you have some there.
Yes, I also have one from another Muslim, and he says, thank you, Papa. Honestly, I am a Muslim, but I always have time for your teachings. Mami Says also says, your teachings are entirely different from the false messages being preached by the false prophets in Ghana. God bless you, Bishop S.N. Mensah.
Indeed, God bless you. I also have one from me, Ali Manyumoda. Says that, Bishop, your great messages must be shared to every living thing. And I think I like this one. It says that, every living thing to hear, they are heavy. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Bishop. Michael Ayepatu also says he was touched after listening to this sermon. He told himself, enough is enough. God bless you, Bishop.
Wes G says that, thank you, sir. You have been a great blessing to my life. I have learned a lot from your teachings. More grace, sir.
More grace, Bishop. Mary Mensah is also wowed by the words and points that are always clear and understanding. She says, more grace, my Bishop. Mercy Mwanzi from Kenya says she is blessed by the teachings from Transformation Hour.
Albert Kujo says, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory be to God Almighty for your life, and once again for using you to bring this powerful revelation to encouraging people in this end time. More grace.
Evangelist James Labby Lotson also says, I am always blessed when I listen to your messages. God bless you highly, man of God. And Humble Richard says, you are speaking life, and every word that you speak, there is power in it to change life. Thank you, Jesus.
Mili Zubila says, I am always overwhelmed whenever you share the words of wisdom from our great God. God bless you.
God bless you so much, Bishop. We have another one from Emrys D. Atkinson, who says, you won my heart, sir. I love you and your father, Jesus Christ. Indeed, Jesus is the reason for all things, and Transformation Hour still continues to bring you messages that are aimed at ensuring that the word of God and the gospel of the kingdom reaches the ends of the earth. So, any more messages?
Sure. Alex Wandi says, powerful words of wisdom. I'm well informed now. God bless you, man of God.
John Say, he says, thanks for the messages. You have now opened my eye well. Indeed, it's an eye-opener. His eyes have been opened well.
Sure. Max Logan says, your teaching motivated, encouraged, and strengthen me whenever I am listening to your preaching. God bless you.
God bless you. And Jebles Nellis from Nigeria is always blessed to listen to Transformation Hour messages. He says, I always love listening to your messages.
Nenejo Dometo says, you are always encouraging us and teaching us reality in life. I really appreciate your teaching. God bless you, Bishop. We'll visit your temple one of these days, and we are always open to welcome guests to visit with us. Let me seize this opportunity to also encourage you, if you are anywhere and you want to fellowship, all our churches are open. Our pastors are waiting with open arms to give you a warm reception to fellowship with them. We have branches across the length and breadth of this country. We also have branches overseas. If you peradventure find yourself in a place where there is no full gospel church, you can join a Bible believing church and make sure that your life is transformed, as we all expect to be in heaven.
We have another message from Nairobi, Kenya, from Eriki Lex Voldemort. And he says, I watch your sermons from Nairobi, Kenya, and I really love them. You are truly a blessing to many that you don't know.
Sure. Ruby Believe says, I am really touched by this preaching. Thank you so much, man of God.
Dope Boy Daisy Rude says, Bishop Samuel N. Mensah, you always inspire me. God
sure,
bless
sure.
you.
He always inspires. Samuel John, anytime I listen to your preaching, I'm always a different person. And that is an evidence of transformation right there for you. You have more.
Yes, there are lots of messages here. I'll take one from It's Bankole Smart. He's also from Nigeria, and he says, I like listening to your message. May God continue to bless you.
Zainab Ibrahim says, thank you, Daddy, for these words. It had really touched my heart. May the Lord Almighty bless you abundantly.
We'll end with another message from Nigeria from Tochukwu John, who says, he is from Nigeria, but he always loves listening to these messages. God bless you all so much for sharing with us your messages and for also encouraging everyone to continue listening to Transformation Hour.
You can also send in your message and it will be read live here during Transformation Hour. We receive these things and we read them so that others will be encouraged, because there may be somebody sitting somewhere going through a challenging time, but your message of encouragement will quicken that person's spirit. So we encourage you, stay tuned to Transformation Hour, watch and share your experiences with us, and we believe that it will be a blessing to someone else. Just as I said before, if you find yourself anywhere, please look for a full gospel church near you and fellowship with us. You can also call any of the contacts that have been shared there, and then our pastors are waiting to pray with you. If you call and the line is engaged, please don't despair. Don't give up. Keep calling, and our pastors will pray with you. And we believe, trusting God, that our life will indeed be transformed. Susan, do you have any message for us?
Yes. Once again, we are encouraged to follow the bishop on all of his social media handles, on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, and on YouTube. All you have to do is to just search Bishop Samuel N. Mensah, and you get to listen and see more life-transforming messages.
More life-transforming messages. We also want to encourage you. You know, these things involves money. So if you want to help us push this gospel, you can pick any of the Momo numbers that we've shared on the screen. We've also shared our bank details. You can just drop in a seed to push this gospel. If you are also an institution who wants to partner with us to ensure this gospel reaches the unreached, we are always welcome. We will give you the opportunity to sow. And we believe that as we are sowing and lives are being transformed, your business will also be transformed. Please, no amount is too small. Just make sure you share it with us, and we believe that the word of the Lord will travel the length and breadth of the world, and other lives will also be blessed. God bless you so much for making time to watch Transformation Hour this day. We hope to meet some other time during Transformation Hour. But for now, we leave you with the peace of the Lord, and we say bye-bye.
Bye. God bless you.
Are you aware that vision chooses your future, your priorities, and as a matter of fact, chooses your friends? What you need as an individual to move to the next phase of life is vision. Bishop S.N. Mensah, the author, of the best-selling book Vision, The Fuel That Drives Leaders, is giving us an inspiring, motivating, and practical agenda on leadership vision that will awaken you to achieve your dreams and encourage leaders in all walks of life.
As an avid reader, I've read many books on vision, from Dr. Miles Morrow, Dr. Oyedepo, George Barna, many great minds. But I must admit, as a reader and a writer myself, that this book is a great book. A man without a vision is a man without a future. And a man without a future will always go back to the past. You know what this book will do for you? It will stop you from going back to the past.
This is a comprehensive book on leadership, one of the rare books that review leadership from various perspectives that surprisingly have never been documented.
The author gives a candid exposition on what leadership is all about as far as a vision is concerned. It doesn't only give you the theories of what a vision is, it also tells you how to go about it. To me, this is an essential and a must-have for every student and every student leader out there.
Now, this book is a very special book that I have come to love, and this book has a lot of information that each and everyone needs to have, especially for students. Because as you are developing yourself, you need to create your own vision, which will help you steer your life towards success and nation building.
When this book is followed diligently and mastered, any leader can be confident of achieving success and making an indelible impact on their generation. This is a must read for everyone, but most especially aspiring leaders.
Vision, The Fuel That Drives Leaders by Reverend S. N. Mensah, has been my companion since it was launched. I have found it very, very, very interesting. I have looked at the case studies provided in the book, and I've applied quite a lot of the principles to my working life. I think that every corporate leader, there's a need for you to have a copy of this book. It will help change things. It will help set you into a new thinking that at the end of the day will provide solution to our customers that we seek to serve.
You can grab copies of this book at the Challenge Bookshop, EPP Bookshop, Community 11 Shell, ANC Shell Shop, and the Assemblies of God Bookshop. For bulk purchases, please contact 054-2599-834 or 055-832038. Remember, a man without a vision is a man without a future.
The small group. Are you a pastor with a small group ministry in a church? Are you looking for ways to make your small groups effective that will lead to church growth? Are you struggling with how to start a small group in your church? Then look no further. Grab a copy of Small Groups Manual by Bishop S.N. Mensah for practical steps in starting small groups and identifying the roles of both leaders and members in keeping a healthy small group. Remember, in the midst of a pandemic where large gatherings are not permitted, the only effective means to keep in touch with your congregation is through the small groups. The small groups are met in homes in the books of art were a strategic part of the greater church and hence remains an indispensable element of church management. For copies of this book, contact the following numbers: 0243-277-084 or 054-2599-834. Remember, a pastor without a small group is a pastor without a church.
Thank you for watching, and we hope you've been blessed. We invite you to join us this and every Sunday for our friendly service at the Full Gospel Church International, Community 1, behind Ogbonu FM, Tema, or at any of our branches across the country. For more inquiries, prayers, and counseling, contact us on the following numbers: 0242-774-308, 0244-973-326, 0244-489-046, 0243-858-207. or 0542-599-834. Visit our website at www.fullgospelghana.org or send us an email at info@fullgospelghana.org. You can write personally to Bishop S.N. Mensah at Bishop Mensah at fullgospelghana.org. Full Gospel Church International, transforming lives on purpose.